of alkenes. Alkanes, reactions, free radical substitution reaction we did, and we discussed all the past paper questions also. So I will discuss more questions under that. And alkenes reactions we have to start today. Reactions of alkenes plus isomerism part. There's a small part I had to do, like about, it will take about 50 minutes. So that racemic mixture, right? I'll summarize the isomerism part again. So those are the areas, actually organic chemistry. Today I posted to your WhatsApp this also. I'll share the screen now. I posted this also to your WhatsApp. This A-level, the syllabus chemistry. This one. Can see in this last year, grade 12 third term. Can you all see the screen? Grade 12 third term. So the last unit 7 to 10. Unit 7 to 10 completely organic chemistry. Organic chemistry. And out of this, so chapter unit 8 and 9 bit lengthy. There are 46 periods allocated here. I have put the number of periods allocated also. 46 periods. And so the middle part is bit lengthy, oxygen and containing organic compound. Then the last part, nitrogen containing organic compound. So all these four, all the functional group of the nomenclature we have done. So this is 7.4. Can you see here? Isomerism part. This is what we are doing now. Organic. Basic concepts of organic chemistry, this isomerism part. Then after that, we had to do the alkenes reactions, reactions of alkenes and the reaction mechanism. Right. In addition to that, 2019 paper, A-level paper, this paper. I think we started this right up to question number. Can someone tell me, like, up to which, those were in the class last week, up to which MCQ we discussed? 2019 general and inorganic 19 paper. I can remember I did some MCQs also here. Or did we complete this? Can someone reply or can unmute and tell me? Or up to 14, okay, Pramudi. Up to 14th MCQ we have done, right? Then 19 paper, we had to complete the remaining inorganic and general and inorganic MCQs. Today I posted new this also, 2020 paper also, right? 2020 paper. How many of you got the, I mean, the passbook 2020 paper? Then no need to get a printout. How many of you got the 2020 paper? Please raise the hand. 2020, the recent the paper. Hard copy, password book or like hard copy. If you got the hard copy, no need to take a printout because I posted that also to WhatsApp. Shara and Winhara, okay. Right. I think you're joining from the same device, no? You have put both the names. Okay, anyway, I hope you both of you have got it, right? Right. 2020 paper. So that one I will discuss after 19 paper, 2020 paper also. I posted this today. So then you have enough time to do it before the next class. Okay. You can get this. If you though, if you have not got it, you can PDF, you can download and keep or else you can take a printout. 2020 paper. Then, so this is the 2020 paper, right? Can you all see the screen? So this paper, I want you to do all the inorganic, general and inorganic MCQs, general and inorganic MCQs. Then today first I'll go through this this is only for grade 30, no? The one that you can see on the screen. This is grade 12 chemistry syllabus. That means grade 12 you have to complete 10 lessons. So that means up to topic 10. That is the end of organic chemistry. The last chapter, 10th lesson, the organic chemistry. Then unit 11 to 14, grade 13, second year work. Grade 13, the last five lessons. That means unit four lessons. So 11, 12, 13, 14. So the last four lessons, actually grade 13, only four lessons, but the 12th unit is very lengthy. Within next week, I'll post that also, the syllabus, and then you can refer. Otherwise, you have to go through the teacher's guide again and again, or the resource book. So you can quickly refer from this, where the content of the syllabus. I have prepared this for the ministry recently, because they are doing this together program and all to list the videos and everything according to this order. But don't share this with outsiders. Now, last week I told you this optical activity, right? This is where I stopped last week, organic chemistry. Every day I give a small theory part, and after that I'm doing the questions, right? I mean, I'll give a summary of the theory. Since you are, have you all done this? If anyone done this, please raise the hand. Isomerism part, organic chemistry, like this cis trans isomerism or enantiomers. Theory, if you have done it, then it's easy. I don't need to explain in detail, or else I'll quickly give a summary of this. So we have done isomerism, almost everything we have done, except this racemic mixture. Right? Please copy down racemic mixture. Can you see here? The word racemic mixtures. You can see the screen, right? Actually, this is not the resource book. This is EdExcel. Book two, like the student book, London A level EdExcel. They have given a perfect, like those students, they have a textbook. So our students, they don't have, you don't have a textbook. You have only the resource book. That also, like, there are some gaps in the resource book also. That's why either of you have this. So they have given nicely everything explained. So last week I told racemic mixture. Please write down racemic mixture. What is racemic mixture? A mixture containing equal amount of enantiomers. Actually, this racemic mixture, it's a Latin word. Can you see here? It's a Latin word. I'll highlight here. You can copy down here itself. Racemus means it's bunch of grapes, right? This was discovered by Louis Pasteur. The racemus here, racemus means bunch of grapes. It's a Latin word. Actually, the French chemist, Louis Pasteur. So pasteurization, the production of milk. So in this, he found in grapes, there's a carboxylic acid called, I'll highlight that also here, then you will remember the story. Something called, what is this called? Tartaric acid. What is called tartaric acid? So this is the structure of tartaric acid. It's a carboxylic acid, organic compound. Now this tartaric acid, there's an optically active carbon. Right? Optically active carbon, no? What is this called? Chiral carbon, chiral center. What is chiral center? Last week I told. What is chiral center? In organic compound, if there are four different groups attached to any carbon atom, if there are four different groups attached to any carbon atom, that is called chiral carbon or chiral center. Sometimes we call it asymmetric carbon atom. Asymmetric carbon, chiral carbon. Sometimes we call it optically active carbon. Those who are doing biology also, you know, this some amino acids are optically active. There's a chiral center in some amino acids also. So this tartaric acid present, how it is related to grapes? This tartaric acid is present in grapes. Tartaric acid is present in grapes. So the racemic means bunch of grapes. So that is why you call it racemic acid. Tartaric acid is present in grapes. In term, the racemic acid was used in the racemic part of the term. So that's how this racemic mixture came. So if there's an equimolar mixture, what is the meaning of equimolar mixture? Means equal amount of both the enantiomer. There are two enantiomers here. One will rotate the plane polarized light clockwise. The other one rotate plane polarized anticlockwise. Can you see this diagram? The left side diagram. So you last week I explained this in detail. I don't take much time today. This is the plane polarized light. So here no plane polarization. I'll put 1, 2, 3, 4. So this bulb emit light in all the direction. That means it's a transverse wave. The oscillation occurs in all the planes, number one. So number two, what happened after the polarizer? So it's become plane polarized light. That means light oscillate only in one plane during the propagation. So then you have a sample tube containing what? Enantiomer. The sample tube contain enantiomer. That means optically active compound. Optically active compound. So what happened after sending this plane polarized light through this optically active compound? Optically active compound. So it can be this one, this tartaric acid, the first enantiomer. So there's I'll put here L and D. I'll tell the reason why L and D. So then what happens? This plane of the polarization, it turns either clockwise or anticlockwise. It turns either clockwise or anticlockwise. That is what happened here, alpha. Can you see here? It is turned by this much. Imagine it's turned by 60 degrees. Now this turned by 60 degrees anticlockwise. So this is the expected path. This is the expected path. So it has turned after sending through the sample optical active compound. So then the viewer can see it has changed. The plane of the polarization has changed. So if this rotation is clockwise, if this rotation is clockwise, so here rotation is clockwise. I am not giving a note here because you are getting the note from the theory class. I am just explaining. Please store this in your head, but you can make a small short note. Don't copy down the paragraph. So you better copy down using your own words under racemic mixture. Racemic mixture means it's an equimolar mixture of the two enantiomers. That means a sample containing equal amount of both the enantiomers. That means we call it equimolar mixture. Can you hear? Equimolar mixture of the two compounds. Sample or mixture containing equimolar mixture of the two enantiomers called racemic mixture. Racemic mixture. Now here, if that containing only the first one, L form, that is called, actually, what is this called? Clockwise. If the rotation is clockwise, we call it dextrorotatory. If the rotation is anti-clockwise, it's a Greek word again, anti-clockwise. I'll highlight here blue. If you want to copy down just the term anti-clockwise. If the rotation is anti-clockwise, then we call it L compound, L form. L means L4, we call it levorotatory. Can you see the word, the lever, this one? Please copy down this. That is the mean, but they will not ask the full word, the name in the exam. Anti-clockwise, if the plane of the polarization is anticlockwise, the compound inside is L form of the enantiomer. The enantiomer has two forms, the L form and the D form. L form will rotate the plane of the polarization anticlockwise. Then if it is the other form, so they are mirror images. I told you the same chemical formula. They have the same physical properties except this optical activity. If you only can write the two enantiomers of the same compound, please write down that, put a stand right. Two enantiomers of the same compound or the isomer, they have similar physical properties. Physical properties same except the optical activity. This topic of this lesson is also optical activity. Except the optical activity, other physical properties of the two compounds, and because same molecular formula, same functional groups, right, molecular weight same, right? Boiling point, melting point, those properties won't change in these two tartaric acid. Only thing is, this is, you can see a OH group. OH group, the left side, it is right side. That means they are mirror images. Mirror images. That's the difference between these two compounds. So if you send, if the sample contained in this first form, L compound, then it, the rotation is clockwise. You imagine if this contain the other compound. So I'll highlight this green D, the second enantiomer. Then what happened? This will rotate clockwise. This will rotate clockwise. Clockwise. Then we call it D form. If clockwise rotation is say 60 degrees, anti-clockwise also, now here is almost around 90 degrees, but anyway, I'll just mark, if the, since I have marked the previous one, if the clockwise rotation is 60 degrees, anti-clockwise also the rotation will be 60. If clockwise 60, that means, right. So we call it plus 60 clockwise. Then this is minus 60 anti-clockwise, like that. Plus 60 and minus 60. Now imagine, now I'll come to the racemic mixture. Now imagine if this contain only L form, the plane of the polarization rotate anticlockwise by 60 degrees. That is, we call it minus 60. If this sample contain, this tube contain the D form, the second, the other form of the enantiomer, then it, the rotation will be clockwise, plane of the polarization clockwise, rotation will be clockwise, by the same degrees. Now, what is the racemic mixture if this contain equal amount of both these? That's called equimolar mixture. But if this contain equimolar mixture of both L and D form, L form and D form of the compound, then I put L in red class, L and D. Then what happened? No change of the plane of the polarization. Then what happened? Output also same as before the sample. No change of the plane of the polarization. This is what I want you to learn. That is what I didn't tell last week. Otherwise, I explained what is the optical electron and everything I explained last week. That means no change of the plane of the polarization. So it's like, again, it's vertical. No change of plane of polarization. No change of plane of polarization, plane of the polarized light. Understood? What? If the sample, if you send plane polarized light through a sample containing equal amount of both the enantiomers, so equimolar mixture of L and D forms, there won't be any change of the plane of polarization. That means the L form is going to rotate this clockwise by 60 or whatever 90 degrees, and the other one also opposite direction by the same degrees, then nothing will happen. So it's like it get cancelled off. Understood? Any questions? So can you write that? What is what you write now under racemic mixture, right? A sample, a mixture containing equal amount of the two enantiomers. You can write down if you want this grapes containing this tartaric acid. So it's formed from the fermentation of grapes, so that both their enantiomers are produced. So how tartaric acid is produced? It is produced during the fermentation of grapes. So you get like the barley, beer and wine you get from grapes, right? When you're drinking wine, you get a slightly acidic taste. I mean, most probably, I think tartaric acid should be present in wine, because wine produced from grapes after the fermentation of grapes. But I will show you that the resource book, they haven't given much information at about at all this isomerism, only a small paragraph. That's why I thought of explaining this isomerism part. They haven't given much information. Yeah, this is enantiomerism, only this much. Page now, resource book, right? Page number 24 and 25. That's it. After that, they have started hydrocarbons. Can you see the screen here? Page number 25, there's a small paragraph. And that's it, enantiomerism. They have not given what is the any of those diagrams. Enantiomerism, that's what. Only this much. Only these two paragraphs. Okay. So that's why I thought of giving a bit information. So this is called asymmetric carbon or chiral at a carbon atom. Those words bit important. Asymmetric carbon or chiral carbon atom. When plane polarized light passed through a solution containing only one enantiomer, plane of the polarization rotate. One enantiomer rotate the plane of polarization in one direction, and the other enantiomer in the opposite direction. As the enantiomer rotates the plane of polarization, they are known as optical isomers. Optical isomers. One rotate the plane of polarization, which rotate the plane polarized light are known as optical active component. Only that much. So that is not enough. You don't know what is plane polarized. So I don't know whether you had done physics in this part yet. Otherwise, you don't know what is this whole plane of the polarization. What is polarized light? Even some students, they don't know. Some teachers, they will give the same note in the school also, enantiomerism. Optical active compound, optical isomers. Right? That's why I give, because in the both Cambridge and EdExcel, so they will nicely explain like this. They have given the how it is evolved, like from where it came. Even it's interesting, you will never forget it. Grapes contain tartaric acid, the Louis Pasteur found it. And not only that, actually you have heard about these polarized sunglasses, these polaroid sunglasses. So that means it's more comfortable to your eyes, those sunglasses. So they are manufactured using these chemical compounds, polaroid sunglasses. So they are a bit expensive than normal sunglasses. Right? So that also they have given in this one. Shall I erase this? Did you all finish copying out? You can take a screenshot of this if you want. Again, I move back to the resume. Resume is a word even, not given in the resource book. I don't know. Okay, anyway, properties of enantiomers. So what is properties of enantiomers? What they have, please write everyone. Enantiomers, they have identical physical properties, except the rotation of plane polarized light. So they rotate the plane of the same angle, like equal angles in opposite direction, right? Enantiomers, they have identical physical properties except the rotation of the plane polarized light. Plane of the polarization of the plane polarized light is rotated by equal angles. If the rotation is plus 60, then the other one is minus 60. Plus 60 means say clockwise, minus 60 means anticlockwise, like that. And then today I gave the topic, what is that? Racemic mixture. What is racemic mixture? A mixture containing equal amount of two enantiomers. Then racemic mixture contain equal amount of two enantiomers. Racemic mixture will not rotate the plane of the polarization of the plane polarized light. Racemic mixture does not rotate, right, plane of the polarization. That's what I wanted to learn. No optical activity by racemic mixture. That means optical activity cancel out, because one is trying to rotate clockwise by 60, the other one is trying to rotate by 60 degrees anti-clockwise, then it's cancel out. The effect cancel out. Okay, so what is this called? What are the two forms? L form and D form. L form means what? L form means it rotate anti-clockwise. Please write it. L form of the enantiomer rotate anti-clockwise. D form of the enantiomer rotate it clockwise. By the same degree, if it is the same isomer, by the same degree, clockwise. But this might happen. Imagine one rotate plus 43 degrees, the other one minus 10. Minus 10 means opposite direction. That means L form. L form minus means anti-clockwise. Plus means clockwise. Positive plus 43 degrees means it's rotate clockwise. Clockwise. Minus 10 means it rotate anti-clockwise. Anti-clockwise. Now, why it is different angles? Because that sample, it indicates the composition of the mixture. So you can get an idea about the composition of the mixture using by comparing these two angles. Okay. And if you want to get copy down this source, this will be a bit of information. This is very useful. No? They have not given this in the resource book. What is the meaning of optical activity? What is the meaning of plane polarized light? What is the meaning of unpolarized light? What is the meaning of polarimeter, polarizer, analyzer, racemic mixture? So this is the definition of racemic mixture, right? So that's it. So that's the end of isomerism part. The cis-trans isomerism and all I explained last week, right? I am not wasting time today also for that same thing. Any questions? Any questions you can ask through the chat or you can unmute and ask. Are your school, the teachers are teaching, no? The government schools, no one is teaching now because of the teachers union, the strike, both principals and the teachers. I think private schools you have, right? Online classes these days. Okay. I think this time also, there's a chance of postponing that again with the fourth wave. Then let's move on to the chemical reactions of alkenes. Can you see this? They have given that, I told you that the sunglasses thing also. I think this part I explained last week, right? Here they have given, I told you that sunglasses here, sunglasses, the material used in some sunglasses. So applications are now you might ask, what are the use of this enantiomers or polarizing natural materials and synthetic materials such as Polaroid can absorb all the oscillations except in a single plane one. That means everything else cancel off except the one in the single plane or maybe vertical or horizontal plane. That's what they have given here. Polaroid sheet. So then you can see it's vertical only. This one in all the planes. Plane polarized light. So I gave a detailed explanation about this now, enantiomers, plane polarized light, everything you should know now. Then I'll move to the today's work. So that is the end of racemic mixture, right? Ideal copy down, what is the meaning of racemic mixture? But mixture containing equal amount of two enantiomers and racemic mixture does not show any optical activity. Racemic mixture does not show any optical activity, and enantiomers of a given compound identical by physical properties identical except the optical activity. That also you should know, right? Okay, and that also you have to cover down the other one that the rotation can be clockwise or anti-clockwise. If one enantiomer the rotation is clockwise and the other enantiomer the plane of the rotation is anticlockwise by the same angle. That means that enantiomers rotate the plane of the polarization by equal angles, not two different enantiomers. The enantiomers are the same compound, right? Then next one we will start today, this organic chemistry reactions. I'll give the reaction summary first. Alkenes. This is the tutorial I have posted to your WhatsApp. Chemical reactions of alkenes from 1996 onwards, all the past MCQs. And there I set up questions also. Then I'll use this Zoom wide screen. All right. So these days, then August holidays, you're free in the morning, right? Weekdays also. All right, right. Then we can have the class even Tuesday early morning, no? Tuesday morning, are you all free, everyone? I'm okay with night also, no problem. During holidays, if you all are from the same school. Because I think one or two of you have the class till 8 p.m., no? Who, Tamasha, right? Right, right. Let's see, let's ask from the others, and if they are okay, then we can do from next Tuesday in the only during August morning, Tuesday morning. Right. Now, only thing is some days I have the, now they are going to change the syllabus now, so that curriculum, the online also now we are working, work from home. Some days I have the morning, Tuesdays, NIE, that chemistry syllabus, like the change now. That's the module preparation workshops. Okay, now write chemical reactions of alkenes. I'll give the summary and after that we'll do the paper questions. Chemical reactions of alkenes. Of alkenes. Right. Chemical reactions of alkenes. If you take alkenes, I'll give the a summary. Let's see this alkene. I put this alkene CH3CH double bond CH2. So this is propene. Propene, right? This is the alkene. Now let's see the type of chemical reactions by this alkene. Okay, number one. If I put into this alkene, bromine, Br2 in nonpolar medium with carbon tetrachloride, in nonpolar medium, bromine, liquid bromine. And then HBr, or else I can put HBr into this, HBr. So the remember the organic chemistry, balancing byproducts not much important. They don't ask balancing physical state like, you know, inorganic chemistry, physical chemistry, physical state matters. Inorganic chemistry balancing all the what is this called, byproducts, main products, oxidation numbers, redox balancing. So no such redox balancing, no oxidation state. So byproducts, main product, physical state not concerning. Organic chemistry, only the main product. And sometimes the byproducts could be important if there's a color change or like for the identification sometimes for the chemical test. Other than that, we are targeting the main product. And some reactions only mechanism. Not all the reactions, you don't get the mechanism. Only for some reactions, they could ask the mechanism. Okay, now I'll put the summary. So you can put any alkene in the middle. I use this alkene. Then HBr in the polar medium, and HBr you can put in peroxide medium also. HBr in peroxide medium, that means hydrogen peroxide medium. HBr in polar medium and HBr in peroxide medium. Peroxide medium. Then you can write next one with dilute H2SO4. Conch H2SO4. You can copy down this. You can copy down this. I put C dot H to SO4. Conk H to SO4. And then what? First conk H to SO4, then what? Then I will use the other reactions also. I'll write the products after that. I'll put the reagent in front of the arrow. Alkaline medium OH minus KMnO4. That means alkaline KMnO4. Alkaline KMnO4. Then next one. This nickel hydrogen. We call it hydrogenation. Platinum hydrogen or nickel hydrogen heating. That is called hydrogenation. Hydrogenation. Then there's one more reaction, very important reaction. I'll put this red. This is very, very important for the organic conversions. Organic conversions. This is with the mercury cation dilute H2SO4. Dilute H2SO4 and dilute H2SO4 and mercury cation, that means catalyst, Hg2+, in the process of mercury cation, it acts as a catalyst. Catalyst. Yeah, that's all main reactions. When you're done, tell me. After that, I'll write the products. Done. So sometimes there's a word this called, I put this number one, we call it bromination. Number one is also known as the, I put here one, that is called bromination. Bromination. Addition of bromine. There are sometimes the common names used. So this is number, I'll put this one, this is called hydrogenation. Number two, this is called hydrogenation. Addition of hydrogen. Addition of hydrogen. Not for all these. For some of this, bromination, hydrogenation. Bromination is number one. Hydrogenation is number two. Hydrogenation of alkene. Sometimes we call it catalytic hydrogenation. Number two is called catalytic because nickel catalyst, in the presence of nickel catalyst, you are heating with hydrogen. Okay, now I'll write the products. First one, you get a CH2CH3. What has happened to them? Okay, I'll write this way, then you'll understand. CH3CH, this double bond is broken down and then H get added like this. CH3CH2CH3, that is called, that means our alkene become alkane. Double bond is broken down and H2 is added. That is called hydrogenation, catalytic hydrogenation. If you heat this alkene with nickel platinum, so nickel low platinum catalyst in the process of hydrogen gas, if you are heating, then you get alkane. That means propene become propane. Propene become propane. Second one, what happens? CH3CH. Double bond CH2. Now bromination, addition of Br. You can write from either side. So here what happened? Br get added. Actually, this can be used as a chemical test for alkene. So we call it bromine is brown. After the reaction, it's become colorless. actually double, not double bond. Double bond is broken down, it becomes a single bond. And here BR. So BR2 double bond is broken down, the phi bond is broken down, and BR2 is added. So we call it bromination. So if you want to write as a chemical test, used as a chemical test, to identify the alkene, as a test to identify alkenes, as a test we can use it, because there's a color change in this, as a chemical test to identify alkenes. After adding bromine, liquid bromine, it's get decolorized as a test for identification of alkenes from alkanes. So from other, that means any unsaturated alkenes are what? Unsaturated. If any compound having a double bond or triple bond, we call them unsaturation. Have you heard about this omega 3, omega 6 fish oil? So that contain double bonds. So omega 3 means at the beginning of the third carbon, there's a double bond. Omega 6, I don't know whether you will learn this in biology. It's most of the parts in biology to learn, to understand, you need a bit of chemistry also. Omega 3, there, that's fat under lipids, you will learn it. Omega 3 means at the beginning of the third carbon, there's a double bond. And omega 6 at the beginning of the sixth carbon, there's a double bond. But some lipids or the fat contain more than one double bond. Then we call it polyunsaturated fat. Polyunsaturated fat means contain more than one double bond in the chain. In the same chain, in two or three different places, there will be a double bond. And if it is monounsaturated means contain only one double bond in the chain. Then the other one is saturated, unsaturated. Unsaturated one can be monounsaturated and polyunsaturated. So monounsaturated and polyunsaturated also can be cis and trans. You have done, no isomerism, cis fat and trans fat. So this trans fat is not good to our health. So because when you are this fried, when you are frying oil, fried rice, fried chicken, fried, if the word frying comes, that means what? The amount of trans fat can increase in your diet. That is not good for your health. Too much trans fat can block your arteries, can deposit inside the arteries and can cause health problem. That means heart diseases, or in other words, heart attack. So therefore, when you buy any food item from the market, please look at the label and check the fat originated from which one, either monounsaturated, polyunsaturated, then it's trans fat, the percentage they have given out of 100 grams of the food diet. That is very good information. We don't just look at, people are just, they search for the taste, color, and the brand and price and everything, but they don't look these things, especially this even biscuits and all, especially the fried ones. So that's a rule, like in the other countries, they had to put all this in because the Sri Lanka, the people aren't reading those things. So they don't know what is the cis fat, trans fat or anything. So they check the price and the other stuff. Right. Anyway, then next reaction. Okay, so I gave now, this one I gave. This one product. And this is the other product on the second reaction, then third one. Third one, you get CH3 mercuric ion. Actually, you get an aldehyde here. It's the terminal one become an aldehyde. In the presence of mercury, you can convert alkene to aldehyde, totally to a different functional group. Under the mechanism, I'll explain this, but here I'll write just the product, okay? It can be ketone even, aldehyde or ketone. It can be aldehyde or ketone. So actually, this can become a ketone. Become CH3. It's a ketone. The next one, HBr in the polar medium. Some of these reactions mechanism we'll be discussing, don't worry how that happens. Not all the reactions, so hydrogenation, The first two actually we are the second one we are doing the this one we are doing the mechanism bromination, but addition of hydrogen, that is no, there's no mechanism. So all the reactions we are not doing the mechanism. Then next one, third one, sorry, this reaction now with HBr, so that is hydrogen halides. We call it addition of hydrogen halides, halo hydrogen addition of HBr. So that means here, what is the main type of reaction of alkenes? If you write the major type of main characteristic reaction of alkenes will be addition, electrophilic addition, addition reaction, because when there's a double bond, the one bond can be broken down and two atoms can be added in place of by breaking down the double bond. So then the next one, right, the product with HBr in the polar medium, CH3CH, here CH2 double bond is broken down, and Br come to the middle, carbon and hydrogen goes to the terminal. What that is the difference between the polar medium and the peroxide medium. In peroxide, which is called Markovnikov rule, the resource book also they have given it. I will show that Markovnikov rule. Hydrogen is added to the carbon containing more hydrogen. Hydrogen is added to the carbon containing more hydrogen. Don't worry. After this, I am doing the mechanism for this HBr mechanism, bromine mechanism. We are discussing. Therefore, you will learn that in detail. Why Br come to the middle? I'll explain under the mechanism. Then next one, addition of HBr in the peroxide medium. Then you get CH3CH. Then you get single bond CH2. And there what happened? Br goes to the terminal. Hydrogen comes to the middle. That is the difference between these two. If you want to get bromine to the terminal carbon, then you can do this way. I think this 2020 paper also, they have given a question from this here. Can you see something similar to that addition of HCl? I'll show that later. They have one 2020 A-level paper also. Then next one. With the alkaline KMnO4. This also can be used as a chemical test to identify alkenes. Then two alkaline medium, two OH groups added to this. Then you get diol. CH3, CH, double bond. Double bond is broken down and it becomes a single bond. Here you can put OH minus, and here you also you can put OH minus. Right. And next one, Pnk2SO4H2O. Yeah, it's like addition of water molecule, to alkene. Sometimes we put OH come to the middle and hydrogen goes to the terminal. It is CH3, CH, OH, and CH3. That means you get here alcohol. You get alcohol, OH is added. That means you can convert alkene into alcohol. So this is very important in organic conversions. You can convert alkene into alcohol. You can convert alkene into aldehyde. You can convert alkene into alkane. That means you can prepare alkanes from alkenes. By hydrogenation, you can prepare halogenated hydrocarbons by adding HBr, Br to HC. Even if you can put your HCl instead of HBr. So those are the main reactions, main type of reactions given in your syllabus and new syllabus. The chemical reactions of alkenes. So this is called sometimes this in the peroxide medium, there's a special name used for this. They call anti-Markovnikov addition. The other one is called Markovnikov addition. Okay. When you're done, tell me. Anyone still copying down this? Okay. Please raise that. Anyone copy now this? Because I'm going to move to the next one. Shall I raise this? Okay. Now let's move to the next one. Now let's see the most important, right here, reaction mechanisms. Now, right, that is a reaction summary I gave. Now I'll give the reaction mechanism. Reaction mechanism of alkenes. Reaction mechanism of alkene. Reaction mechanism of alkenes. Reaction mechanism of alkenes. Okay. Under this first one, let's see mechanism for actually you can write here within bracket the main characteristic reaction of alkene is addition reaction. So actually main type of reaction of alkene will be electrophilic addition. I'll tell the reason what I mean of electrophilic, right? Electrophilic addition. Alkenes are unsaturated. After the reaction, it gets saturated. Main type is electrophilic addition. I'll tell you what is the meaning of electrophile. Now let's see the mechanism for the addition of Br2. Addition of Br2. Or we call it bromination. What is called bromination? Bromination of alkene. What is bromination? Addition of Br2 in the presence of CCl4, because in the polar medium OH minus also can be produced, then the reaction is more complex. So this is what happened. If you the reaction mechanism, they can ask in the structured essay paper or A-level paper or even essay type paper. So if you take this reaction, so I'll put this one CH2, double bond CH2. Then you put, I put the reaction also here just to recall CCl4, then you get CH2Br and here you get CH2Br. So then brown color get decolorized. Brownish color of decolorization of bromine. Brown color of bromine get decolorized. That's why it can be used as a chemical test to identify alkene from the other organic compounds without double bonds. Now let's see the mechanism for this reaction. Mechanism. This is how it happens. About CH2. Double bond. Nitrogen. Right. So what happened when you put Br2? Br2 is nonpolar molecule, right? But it can get slightly polarized in the presence of when it approached to the 5-electron cloud of the alkene. That means when in the presence of alkene, Br2 can get slightly, like you have heard about this induced dipole inducer, something like that. Similar to that, there will be a temporary dipole. Then it can undergo heterolytic bond breaking instead of homolytic bond breaking. I'll use a different color for that, Br2. When it approached towards this alkene, it gets slightly polarized like this, delta plus and delta minus. Now what happens? This delta plus, it can withdraw the 5 electron from the double bond. So what is curly arrow represent? The electron shifted from the 5 bond towards the electron lacking Br plus. So Br delta plus, it's the electron deficient or electron lacking. So that's why this can be considered as an electrophile. This can be electrophilic. Electrophilic means the one who attracts towards the electron. The one who attracts towards the electron, electrophilic. Hydrophilic means the one who attracts, one who get attracted towards the water, hydrophilic, like that. The one who get attracted towards the electron rich place called electrophilic. Electrophilic, electrophile has less electron. That's why it's getting attracted towards the electron rich place, electrophilic. That means Br plus an electrophile. It's electrophilic. So then when it receive the electron from the double bond, then this bond become, the existing bond become unstable. The existing bond become unstable and it is broken down like this. So these electrons are given to Br delta minus. That means the bond breaking take place here. Bond breaking occurs. We call it heterolytic bond breaking. That means both the electrons are shifted towards Br minus. Then you get a compound like this, the intermediate like this, intermediate like this. This is the intermediate. You get here Br plus. So this Br get attached to both the carbons now, and it carries a plus charge. And in other than that, then you get Br minus separately. This Br minus comes separately like this. Now what happened in the, this is the intermediate. And this Br minus rich in electrons, then it attack this carbon and this bond is broken down. I'll use the curly arrows with the same color I used red earlier. This curly arrows, the direction important. And it represents the shifting of electrons like this. Use the curly arrows, like my one is not that sharp. Right. This is broken down. Then you get the final product like this. CHH. Here you get Br and here also you get Br. Okay, this Br get added to this carbon and then you Br minus come to this. So this is the mechanism. So this is bromonium ion. What is this? Middle one is called the intermediate. This is the intermediate, which is called intermediate. Intermediate ion is known as bromonium ion. Bromonium ion. Right. So that is the mechanism for the bromination. Bromination mechanism you should know. You have to remember. Then next one. Now let's see. Addition of HBr. The mechanism for the addition of HBr in polar medium. Peroxide medium, they don't ask the mechanism. Right. Addition of HBr in the polar medium. Shall I erase this? Anyone still copying down? So what is this mechanism type known as? This mechanism type is called what? Mechanism type is known as, please highlight this, electrophilic addition. What is it called? Electrophilic addition. Why it is called addition? Br2 is added to the alkene. Now alkene become alkane. Now these things also they can ask in the exam, right? What is the hybridization of this alkene, the carbon? sp2. Now the hybridization has changed from sp2 to sp3 now, right? And this is unsaturated. unsaturated compound has become saturated. Saturated. And the color, there will be a color change during this reaction also. That also remember. So what is this mechanism type you should know? The electrophile you should know. Electrophile is Br plus. That electrophile, right? That's a bit important. And the mechanism you have to remember, the reaction you have to remember, the main product you have to remember. Byproducts, they don't ask. The main reaction you should know and the mechanism you should know. And the type of reaction, electrophilic addition, mechanism type, and the mechanism you should know how to write. The hybridization also, there will be a change. And the geometry around carbon atom also, there will be a change. Now this is trigonal planar around the geometry around carbon atom. Is that it has become tetrahedral geometry after the reaction. Any questions? Any questions? Right. Then next one. I'll move to the next one. Let's see. Next one, right, second one, number two. Addition of HBr. What is this called? Addition of HBr. Or we call it addition of hydrogen halides. Addition of hydrogen halides. Addition of, this is a bit important. Addition of hydrogen halides. Okay. Let's see the first one. I'll use the most simplest alkene, CH2CH2. I'll use here HBr. HBr. So when I use HBr, what happened? This become CH2. That means double bond is broken down and hydrogen come to here and bromine goes to the other side. Or else you can write like this CH3CH2Br. That means halogenated hydrocarbon. So this is in the polar medium. Or you can put water. Now what happens? This is a mechanism. Mechanism. I'll put the mechanism. So it's HBr. Now here delta plus. And here delta minus HBr is a polar covalent bond. Polar covalent bond. Now what happens? The H plus act as an electrophile. H plus act as an electrophile, and this H plus get attached to one of the carbon. Remember, this arrow is pointed from electron rich place. So electron rich place is phi bond. Towards the electron lacking person, that is electrophile. What is this? This act as electrophile. H plus act as electrophile. Electrophile lacking electrons and it's get attracted towards the electron. So if you put the arrowhead the opposite direction, then no marks in the exam. Some instrument they put the arrowhead towards the double bond. That is wrong. Arrowhead is always towards the positively charged ion. So when hydrogen receive electron, because this is a polar covalent bond. Then this is unequal sharing of electrons. Then this bond is not that stable, not like high H2, right? Not like H2. Therefore, this Br, the two electrons of the covalent bond, then shifted towards Br and Br become Br minus. H get added to alkene. So then I'll put the arrow and put the intermediate. Then you get this compound, the intermediate. Put this electrophile. Right. Now what happens? You get the intermediate. So hydrogen is added to one of this carbon. You can put hydrogen into either one of this, no problem. Either one of this. So I put this one, no problem. Then H come to this carbon and then this become positive. Plus. And you get Br minus. Br minus. So this Br minus come to this carbon in the next step. And you get the final product. This is the mechanism for the addition of hydrogen halide. So addition of HBr. Then you get CH2, here hydrogen, and here you get CH2Br or CH3CH2Br. That is the mechanism. So this one has lone pairs. That's why it's Br minus. That is the mechanism. So what is this called? Again, the mechanism type called electrophilic addition. What is the mechanism type? Electrophilic addition. Now, sometimes you can argue, sir, can't we write this one the other way around? Can't we write the hydrogen to this carbon? No, I put hydrogen to this left side. Sometimes you might ask, sir, can't we put hydrogen to the other side? Can, no problem. Same thing, you can turn this completely upside. I mean, by 180 degrees, if you turn, then no problem. The same thing, right? If you put hydrogen this side, that also same. Nothing, the same compound. This can be interchanged because you can turn this by 180 degrees, then you will get the other one. So because both the carbons are identical, therefore you can put hydrogen to either side. If you write that using onwards, hydrogen can be added to either side of the carbon since both the carbons are identical here. Both the carbon symmetrical, so symmetrical carbon CH2 identical. Therefore you can put hydrogen, first hydrogen, you can put to either side and then Br, so vice versa, you can get it. Shall I move to the next one? The next one is a bit difficult than this. This one. Shall I erase this? Anyone still copying down? Done, right? Okay. Now I'll give the next one. It's a bit more. Now, if you get alkene, the same reaction. Now, this is very important. Number, Roman number two, right? Addition of HBr again. This compound. CH3. Now, this is very, very important. CH3CH double bond CH2. Now, what happens? You can, if you add HBr, this can occur in two different methods. If you add HBr into this in the polar medium, there are two possibilities. One possibility will be hydrogen come to the terminal and bromine come to the middle. Hydrogen come to the this one and the other come to the other one come to the middle. That is one method. The other one, there are two possible compounds. And then we have to decide which one will be the major product. I'll write both the possible. Now one possibility is what? Now here the double bond, around the double bond, carbon atoms are not symmetrical. It's not symmetrical. Then there will be two different compounds. So one method is bromine come to the middle and hydrogen come to the terminal. And the other product, there can be two different products. So the other possibility, hydrogen come to the middle and bromine added to the terminal carbon. There's two possibilities. Now this will be the major product and the other one will be the minor product. That means higher percentage, the first one. I will tell the reason now why it is the major product. This one will be the, I'll highlight the major product. Then you will understand this from the mechanism. Now I'll give the mechanism. Why the first one is the main product, I'll tell now. Okay. CH3, I'll write the mechanism. CH3CH double bond CH2. Now, what is the mechanism? Same as earlier, HBr, delta plus, delta minus. Okay. I lose the curly arrows. From the double bond, electrons are withdrawn towards the positively charged electrophile and this bond is broken down. Then you get the first intermediate like this. You can see the screen clearly, right, everyone? Now, I'll write like this. If you take CH3, now there are two possibilities. If hydrogen get added to the, there's two possibilities now. I'll put this one, CH3, CH2. Now I'll put hydrogen is added to the terminal carbon. And this become plus. And here you have the Br minus. And the other one, CH3, hydrogen is added to the middle carbon and this become plus. This is then Br minus here. So this is, this intermediate is known as what? Carbocation. What is this intermediate called? There are two intermediates. So if the reaction occurs through the first path, so this is called secondary carbocation. This is very, very important. I'll write with a different color. What is called secondary carbocation? Secondary carbocation. This is called primary carbocation. Can you remember the primary alcohol, secondary alcohol like that you had learned before? Because you can see this positively charged carbon, there are two alkyl groups. Around this positively charged carbon, there are two alkyl groups, CH3 group, both sides. That's why you call secondary carbocation. Two R groups attached. But in this one, only one R group is attached. Around this, only ethyl group is attached. So this side hydrogen, right? Secondary carbocation has only one hydrogen. Primary carbocation has two hydrogen. Primary carbocation. Which carbocation is more stable? Primary carbocation. Primary carbocation. Now this one acts as electron repulsing group. Always these alkyl groups act as electron repulsing group like this. They repel electrons towards what? Towards the carbon, positively charged carbon. So here only one, from one side only electrons are repelled. So this one, the first one, the plus charge magnitude decrease, right? From both side electron repulsing groups attach. Therefore, the secondary carbocation is more stable. It is more stable. Right here within bracket, more stable. Primary carbocation is less stable. This is very, very important. This mechanism is extremely important. When I discuss the questions today, you will understand how important this mechanism. Please put four stars near this mechanism. All right, what is this carbocation? This is called primary carbocation. Why is primary carbocation? Only one alkyl group, this whole thing called one alkyl group, CH3, CH2, we call it ethyl group. And this carbon from the other side, only two hydrogen. But this side, there are two alkyl groups, CH3 groups, and there's only one hydrogen. Hydrogen cannot repel electrons. Only alkyl groups can repel electrons or can supply electrons towards the positively charged carbon. Then the magnitude of the carbon atom, the plus charge magnitude decrease. Why? Magnitude of this charge density decrease. Why? Because of the repulsion, of the electron from both sides. When the magnitude of the plus charge decrease, the stability increase. That's why I wrote here more stable. When there are more alkyl groups around the carbocation or positively charged carbon, the magnitude of the plus charge decrease. When the magnitude decrease, it become more stable. That means the stability increase. But the other one, what happened? The stability is less. Why? Only one alkyl group. So the primary carbocation is less stable. Primary carbocation is less stable. So I'll write here within bracket, less stable. Less stable than the first one. Now the reaction occurs mainly through which carbocation? Through the primary carbocation. So now what happened? I'll write the next step in the reaction. Then this Br minus attack this, and you get the two products. You get the two products. That means major product and the minor product. Major product and the minor product. So the same thing what we wrote earlier under the main product of the reaction. Then you get here CH3. Then now Br come to the middle position because the middle carbon is plus, and here it's become CH3. Right. Here what happened? CH3, CH2, CH2Br. Right. Is that clear now? What is the major product now? The first one will be the major product. This is the major product. Major product. So major product is formed through the most stable carbocation. Major product formed through the most stable carbocation. Because most stable carbocation is, that means reaction occurs or reaction prefers through the secondary carbocation than the primary carbocation. Remember, before the main product is 2-bromo, what is this? What is the name? IUPAC name here? 2-bromoethane. This is 1-bromoethane. 2-bromoethane and 1-bromoethane. So this major product, why this become major product? That means higher percentage of this form. Why higher percentage of this form? Because that is formed through through the secondary carbocation. If the intermediate is more stable, that reaction is more likely to happen. If the intermediate as well as the products are unstable, that reaction is unlikely to happen. So the feasibility of the reaction depends on the stability of the intermediate and the main product. Before the main product, you should get the intermediate. The intermediate will be the secondary carbocation or this either primary or secondary carbocation. If intermediate is unstable, that intermediate is less likely to form. That unstable intermediate is not going to form much because it's unstable. If the intermediate is unstable, then you can't get the product higher percentage. But if the intermediate is more stable, then that intermediate is going to form. So always the you had no entropy also, or the things are going from the stability increase, energy is lowered, so that when the stability is increased, that product is more stable, long lasting. If the products and the intermediates are unstable, then they are not going to last for a longer period, so that they are not going to form much because they are unstable. Now also in the world, what happened from COVID? Who will die first? People with weak organs, they are unstable. Their stability is less on the earth under pandemic situation. Elderly people, elderly population rapidly decreasing, and people with weak organs, especially if someone get infected with COVID, then higher risk for the people with, weak organs, in other words, chronic diseases like diabetics, heart problems. So that means their organs are weak. If someone having diabetic, most of the organs are weak. Kidney is weak, liver. If someone is consuming alcohol, then liver is weak. If someone is smoking, the lungs are weak. Those who are smoking, they are going to get disappeared from the earth first before the others, those if they get infected from COVID. So they are unstable. So higher risk for them. Something like that. And they are not going to, that means from them, less chance of producing the next generation, because sometimes even a small one age below 30 or 20, maybe a age below 20 at your age, if someone get infected from COVID with weak organs, then before he gets sexually matured, before he is going to marry and have children, he is leaving this world. So he is unstable, that intermediate is unstable. So therefore, he cannot produce the next generation. No products from him, right, or her. Something like that. But anyway, so that's what they're suffering. So we can't help. Therefore, after the COVID-19, the elderly population in the world decreased. The people with weak organs, because then it's good for the government. Government no need to make the pension for anything. So the pension demand decreased. It's good for the government of any country, because they have to maintain this elderly population. There's no income, from them, like, because they are dependent. Government is not getting a benefit from them because they are not working, and they have to maintain elderly population, the free health service and all. So then less risk for government is good for the government. And people with weak organs, again, free health service, then kidney problem, liver problem. So then they have to, they get medication from the government hospitals then. So that will decrease, no? Population will decrease. Right. Shall I erase this? I gave enough time to copy down. So what I have to copy down now? Reaction occurs mainly through the secondary carbocation. Now I'll tell the three types of carbocation after this. Therefore, remember this is very, very important. So how to identify that? When you are given a carbocation, you should know whether it's primary or secondary, right? When there are two alkyl groups attached, then it's secondary carbocation. When there's only one alkyl group or R group attached, this is primary. That means CH plus secondary, CH2 plus primary carbocation. Then tertiary carbocation also there. Therefore, reaction occurs through the most stable carbocation. Most stable carbocation is secondary carbocation with compared to primary. That's why the this will be the major product. Is that clear now? Any questions? Then I will move to the next one. Now I'll tell the stability of carbocation, the comparison. From this part, you are getting a lot of questions. The stability of carbocation. Stability of carbocation. Please copy down this. I'll write like this. If I write here CH3, CH2 plus, what is this? Primary carbocation, that is less stable. If I put CH3, CH plus, and CH3, this is what? Secondary carbocation. And the other one is CH3, C plus, CH3, CH3, what is called? Tertiary carbocation. There are three R groups attached. Please copy down this everyone. All right, here below first one, right? Primary carbocation. Primary carbocation. It is the least stable one. This is secondary carbocation. You can write in short form if you want. Secondary carbocation. This is next one, tertiary carbocation. Tertiary carbocation. So you can write here, put an arrow and write. Stability increases across, so here the stability increases. Why is stability increase? Because they act as repulsing groups. It's an act as repulsing group. So this is only one electron repulsing group. I will mark that with the green. So here there are two electron repulsing groups. Here there are three electron repulsing groups. So the magnitude of the plus charge decreases when there are more alkyl groups, when there are more electron repulsing groups, the magnitude of the plus charge decreases, then the stability increases. The stability increases. So reaction occurs. So the electrophilic addition occurs most mainly through which carbocation? Through the most stable carbocation. So that's now that's why the previous one, the one become the major product. You don't get 50-50 from each. There's one more thing you have to learn. Now, if there's a, I mean, this kind of situation also arise. If you have CH3, C, if you have a double bond attached to this, then the stability further increase. When there's a carbocation here, and this can undergo resonance, that's why. Minus CH3, and there's a plus charge here. Now this is tertiary carbocation. If there's a double bond on the adjoining carbon to the positively charged carbon, the stability further increase. that also can, when there's a double bond, can undergo resonance. When there's a double bond adjoining to the carbocation, carbocation, comma, the stability further increase. Stability further increases. Stability further increases. When there's a double bond adjoining to the carbocation, the stability further increases. That is due to the resonance stabilization. This is due to resonance stabilization. Can you remember when there are more resonance structures for a given intermediate, the stability increases? Can you please put a stand right? When there are resonance structures for a given, when there are more resonance structures of a given intermediate, the stability further increase. When there are more resonance structures of a given intermediate, when there are more resonance in an intermediate, its stability further increase, because that plus charge get delocalized around the other atoms. Stability further increases. Please copy on that. Stability further increases. When there are more resonance structures of an intermediate, the stability further increase. So the in addition, then both the factors will contribute. The stability of the carbocation, as well as the, it depends on the resonance stabilization also. When then this plus charge get delocalized on the other atoms. The plus charge gets delocalized on the other atoms, then the stability further increase. So in the exam, don't write the minor product. Like for the organic conversions, you have to write the major product. Unless they ask, you don't need to write the minor product. So what is this? Electrophilic addition reaction of alkenes, addition of HBr. Shall I erase this? Anyone still copying down? Now we can start the questions. Shall I raise this? Anyone still copying down? Please raise the hand. Okay. Now I will share the paper. Sorry. Can you see this? His 2020 paper. This is what we, okay, I'll discuss this also before I do the paper. Can you guess the answer for this? This is 2020 paper, LL paper, MCQ. This is from alkene reaction here, addition of HCl. Only difference, there I put HBr and here HCl. That means what? Electrophilic addition. Now what will happen? Okay, what is the short method? You remember in the previous one also, you remember hydrogen is, what is the short method? Okay. What is the short method here? Hydrogen is added. Okay. If you want to write here, what is the short method? Okay. Can you see the screen again? Hydrogen is added to the carbon containing more hydrogen. How to remember the major product? Hydrogen is added to the carbon. Look at this major product. Hydrogen is added to the terminal carbon that contain more hydrogen. So write in short form, when adding HBr, hydrogen is added to the carbon containing more hydrogen. That's how you can easily remember. Hydrogen is added to the carbon containing more hydrogen. Which carbon containing more hydrogen out of the double bond? CH2. The other one is CH. So CH2 contain more hydrogen. To that carbon, H get added. That's why the rightmost side H added, Br is added to the middle. So Br is added to the carbon contain less hydrogen. That is CH, only one hydrogen. The middle carbon, only one hydrogen. Terminal carbon, two hydrogen. That is a short method to remember this. Is that clear? Now gradually the organic chemistry is going to be little and little harder with time, because I started with the simpler stuff, right? Otherwise, if I start with the hardest one, then you will hate organic chemistry also, right? Okay. Now I'll stop this again. Okay, I will share the paper. Now I want you to get the answer for this. Again, I am telling hydrogen is added to the carbon content more hydrogen. And ClBr is added to the carbon container, less hydrogen. Can you tell me the answer for this? From what you learned now, alkyl halide is the product you get. Now they have a major product. How to decide the major product? Okay, shall we draw the major product? How to get the major product? Hydrogen is added to the carbon containing more hydrogen. Then you get here CH3, CH, C, CH3, here CH3. Now what happened? Which carbon, before Br comes, that should be plus. If Br come to here, then this should be, before Br comes, this should be plus. Which one is better to become plus? The right side carbon or middle carbon? I mean the right side or no, left side one? Which carbon cation is more stable if I put the plus charge? Tell me, first one or second one? Better to become which one plus? First carbon or second carbon? Number two or number one? Now if the second carbon become positive, then it's tertiary carbon cation. If this one become plus, then it's secondary carbon cation. Which carbon cation is more stable? Tertiary carbon cation or secondary carbon cation? Secondary or tertiary? I'm asking number two become plus better or number one become plus better. That's what you decide. If that become plus, the Br come to that carbon. Yeah, tertiary, obviously. So number two, yeah, good. So then it's better to become this one plus. To that point, the Br will come. And hydrogen come to this one. That's why I told you hydrogen is added to the carbon containing more hydrogen. If after adding hydrogen to the carbon containing more hydrogen, Br added to the other carbon. That's it. Very easy, not hard. But you should know how to explain that. Huh? Why Br come here? Because when hydrogen is added to the middle carbon, this become plus. That point the Br will come. Because Br is minus, the carbon should be plus. Then what can you write the IUPAC name? Now see how tricky the question. Now they want to check whether you know the IUPAC name. If you don't know how to write the IUPAC name for this compound, then finish. This is not bromine. Huh? Sorry, this is chlorine. This is Cl. Yeah. Now, what is the IUPAC name? Shall I make this CH2? This one you can write as CH2, right? If you want this middle one, you can write as CH2. So what is the longest carbon chain? From which chain you have to start numbering? Now you need the IUPAC name. If you don't know how to write the IUPAC name, then you can't evaluate it. Can you please tell me the IUPAC name or number in? Should start from which end? What is the longest chain? Substitute group should get the lowest number. So I'll have to start number from this side. 1, 2, 3, 4. Don't look at the name. Let's write our name and then see whether that name is there. Yeah. Okay, Pramodhi, I told you when adding HBr, so there are two methods, HCl here. Either I can add HCl this side, blue one, that is one method. Look at this, or else I can add HCl like this way. Hydrogen to the Cl to the middle and hydrogen to this one. So I have to add HCl into this. So I'm now both will not be more stable. So one will be more stable than the other one. So which one is more stable? Adding chlorine to the carbon content in more hydrogen or less hydrogen. I mean, adding, I told you, remember this way, adding, I told you hydrogen should be added to the carbon content in more hydrogen to get the major product. To get the major product, hydrogen should be added to the carbon content in more hydrogen. Which carbon content in more hydrogen? This carbon. To that one, we have to add hydrogen. Then to the other carbon, you have to add chlorine. Then double bond is broken down. Double bond is broken down. So before chlorine is added, that has to be positive. Now Pramodi asked me to explain that again. That's why I'm explaining. Which one become, if this one become positive, then hydrogen should be added to the middle carbon first. First hydrogen get added and then the chlorine is added. First hydrogen is added and then the chlorine is added. So if you add hydrogen to this one, then this become plus. What is this? Tertiary carbocation. That is a tertiary carbocation. So I'll write here CH3, CH2, CH3. What is this? Tertiary carbocation. There are three alkyl groups. This side ethyl group repels an electron. This side methyl group repels an electron, this side methyl group. So there are three alkyl groups attached. That is called tertiary carbocation. So therefore, the reaction occurs through the tertiary carbocation because that is more stable. That is very stable. Is that clear? Then what is the other option? If I add hydrogen to the other carbon, then you will get like this away. Look at this now. I'll write the other one also. What is the other alternative method? I can add hydrogen to this carbon. CH3. You can see the white screen also, right? If I add hydrogen to the other carbon, H here. Then this become plus. What is this called? Secondary carbocation, because only this become this whole thing become one alkyl group, and here the other alkyl groups, then it's become what? Secondary carbocation. If you get this one from this, what is the product you get? CH3 CH, then Cl will come to this one, the middle one, and this becomes CH CH3 CH3. Here you can see this is from the secondary carbocation and the other one from the primary carbocation. Which carbocation is more stable? Is it tertiary carbocation? Tertiary carbocation. So which carbocation is more stable? Tertiary carbocation. That's why Cl come to the middle one and that become the major product. This become the major product. Is that clear? This become the minor product, Pramodi. This become the minor product. Because minor product come from the secondary carbocation, major product come from the tertiary carbocation. Why it become the major product? Because tertiary carbocation is more stable. The reaction occurs through the second tertiary carbocation, which is more stable. Reaction mostly prefers through the more stable carbocation, which is tertiary carbocation. That's why they ask in the first statement, what is the name of the major product form? Chlorine come to the second carbon or chlorine come to the third carbon? I mean, chlorine to the middle or terminal, that's what they ask. Is that clear now, the Pramodi? Did you, you need more explanation? Okay. Okay, if you haven't doubt, yeah, you can ask. I'll explain again, because otherwise, if you don't understand the concept, no point even doing even 1,000 questions, right? Now, see whether the first statement is correct. Write your name now. Your name is like this. Name of this main product. 1, 2, 3. What are the two alkyl groups? So, substitute group. Chloro there, methyl there. Then what should, alphabetical order, what should come first? Chloro. No? 2-chloro. 2-chloro. Then 2-methyl. 2-methyl. What is this? Butane. methyl butane, yeah, for carbon butane. Methyl butane, methyl and butane, no space. So that is correct. Major product is that. That's true, right? That's correct. Okay. Then next one. Okay, can you tell me the answer now? Can you go through? Okay, first one I'll explain again. Can you go through the other statement and tell me the answer? This last year old paper. B also correct, no? That also can be formed, but that will not be the main major one. Yeah. Okay. Some of you gave. What about the others? Okay. Pramodi gave A and C. Vinhara and Ishara gave A and B. Tamasha? What would be correct? A correct. B also correct. What about C and D? HCl bond is cleaved. Cleaving means what? Cleaving means bond breaking. Will that form a radical? No. Free radical, chlorine radical is not formed. Cl minus, ne? Cl minus is not a radical. Ne? Cl minus only attack. Ne? In this one, the Cl, okay, I'll write here. Cl minus come and attack this. Not Cl radical. Ne? Cl minus will come and attack to this carbon. That's how you get the product. After first H is added, first H is added to this, and then Cl is added. C is wrong, right? C is wrong. Remember, free radical, I think you were there, no? For the alkane, free radical reaction occurs with alkanes only, not with alkenes. But peroxide medium, free radical can be formed. In one of the steps of a reaction, nucleophile reacts with the carbocation. In one of the steps, a nucleophile means new, what is nucleophile? Nucleophile, that means the agent which is rich in electron. Okay, I'll tell that also. Nucleophile means, okay, what are the two things called? Electrophile and nucleophile. Okay, can you all please write down that also here? Otherwise you can decide D here. What are the two type of reagents in organic chemistry? One is electrophile, the other one is nucleophile. Electrophile, please copy down this. Electrophiles are mostly electron lacking agent. Nucleophile is opposite. Nucleophile means electron rich people. Cl minus, so rich in electrons. OH minus, rich in electron, because there are OH minus, negatively charged ion, or ammonia can act as a nucleophile because of the lone pair. Molecules with negatively ions with negatively charged ions, OH minus, Cl minus, Br minus, and molecules with lone pairs of electrons can act as nucleophile. Nucleophile means what? Electron rich. Electron rich nucleophile. Electron deficient one. Electron lacking one called electrophile. Electrophile love electrons because that one is lacking. The person who is not having enough money, they love money more than the other people, right? That electrophiles are mostly positively charged ion. So H plus, Br plus, delta plus, like that. They are electrophile. Electrophiles are mostly positively charged. Nucleophiles are negatively charged. So in one step, the nucleophile involved. No, look at here. In the next step, first step, H is added. first step HCl. Next step, what happened? Cl minus added. Cl minus is nucleophile. First H is added, that is electrophile, and then nucleophile is added. Is that clear? So the reaction we name based on the first attack. So HBrO HCl delta plus one electrophile, this is delta minus one nucleophile. But who will attack the double bond first? Electrophile. Who attack the double bond first? Electrophile. So from the double bond, electrophile withdraw electrons. That's how we call it electrophilic addition. Then Cl minus is this one is broken out like this. Understood? Then the next step, the Cl minus attack the fossil charged carbon. So that's what they have done in one of the steps. That means the second step. Look at your previous mechanism. You copy down. Nucleophile reacts with the carbocation. Yes. This carbocation react with Cl minus. That is a nucleophile. Nucleophile. If you want to write about nucleophile, write Cl minus. That is correct. Ne? That is correct. That means D also correct. D also correct. So what is the answer now? A, B, D. Answer is 5. Answer is 5. Answer is 5. A, B, D. Yeah, Tamasha, very good. A, B, D. Very good. Now, did you understand? Now you know, understand. Now, that's why I told you. I asked you to put 3 stars for that. That mechanism, that carbocation, primary, secondary, tertiary carbocation, major product, minor product, that is the most frequently asked question under this section, under the reactions of alkenes. In LL, most of the past papers also they have asked. This last year paper also they have asked. Okay. Now, what again, if I summarize, what did you learn now? You learn what are electrophiles, what are nucleophiles. Then you learn primary, secondary, and tertiary carbocation. Then you learn how to decide major product and minor product when hydrogen halides, that means HCl, HBr, reacts with alkenes. And I gave the reactions of the reaction summary of alkenes, but all the reactions you are not getting the mechanism in the paper. What is the main characteristic reaction of alkenes? Electrophilic addition. Why? Alkene contain 5 bond. 5 bond rich in electrons. So electron rich person always get attracted to the electron lacking one. They are attracted negative and positive. So therefore, that's why it's electrophilic addition. Otherwise, you can tell nucleophilic addition. Always remember, we name the mechanism type based on the first attack. What is the first attack here? H plus. So I put number 1 and 2. Above this black arrow, I'll put number 1. Above the blue arrow, I put number 2. This is the first attack. After that, this B, Cl minus come. If you only can put 1 and 2. First, what happened? Above the black arrow, I'll put number 1. Right? Number 1. Above the blue arrow, I'll put number 2. So therefore, first, the double bond react with whom? H plus, not with Cl minus. Therefore, that is called electrophile. H plus will be electrophile. Electrophile. He is electrophile. And he is a nucleophile. But we name the reaction based on which one? Based on the first attack, number 1, arrow, curly arrow number 1. So the reaction begins with that part. That's why we call it electrophilic addition. Otherwise, the nucleophile also involved in the next step, second step. But we don't name the reaction type as nucleophilic addition. So right here, this mechanism type, call it nucleophilic addition. So again, you get set of questions in the A-level paper. They will give a table. You get the first column, the reactant. Second column, you get the reagent. They will ask you to complete the rest. Third column, what is the electrophile? What is the nucleophile? And name the type of mechanism. What is the type of mechanism? I'll do that one next day. There are a lot of questions. Even today, I can show those questions. So therefore, I am putting more weight on the areas where you get more questions. When I do the paper class, I'll put more weight on which areas, the areas where you get more questions. Some parts I don't explain much at all. My explanation, the length, depends on the contribution of that section to the your paper. Based on that only, I'll. Right. Done. Shall I read this? Is that clear? Any questions? Any questions based on this? Right. Shall I will erase this. Okay. Then this we'll discuss next day. This paper I'll discuss. All compartment show diastole. Ah, see this one diastole. Can I this is C45. 2020 A-level paper. Can you tell me the answer for this also? 45th, did I discuss this with you? No, right? You can tell me the answer for that also. See, organic chemistry, that was organic chemistry. All the compounds and double bond show is diastereoisomerism. And any two isomers which are not mirror images of each other are diastereoisomers. Mirror images means enantiomers. I told you that optical active thing. Mirror images are means optical isomers or enantiomers. Today I explained at the beginning. Any two isomers are not, which are not mirror images. Now isomers, I gave a summary at the beginning. Check with your writing book. Isomers, I gave a summary. Other than optical isomers, so enantiomers, what are the other type of isomers? Yes. Diastereoisomers. And is that only the, other than mirror images, the other one is only the diastereo. Diastereo means cis trans. Diastereo means cis trans. Can you please tell me the answer for this also? Cis trans. Diastereo means cis trans. But can you remember the summary of the isomerism? Okay, let's see. I had to remind that also, I think. Isomerism, I gave a summary like this. I told you, you can see the question, right? Isomerism divided into two types. Structural isomerism, and stereoisomerism. Stereoisomerism again divided into what? Diastereoisomerism and you have this, nothing new. I have given this summary at the beginning and the isomerism topic. Diastereoisomerism and enantiomers. Enantiomerism. Diastereoisomerism again divided into what? Cis isomerism and trans. Cis and trans. Diastereoisomerism shown only by whom? The ones having double bonds. Only by alkenes. Diastereoisomerism only by alkenes. Only by alkenes. There must be a double bond. Diastereoisomerism. Then enantiomerism, what is the requirement? There must be a carbon, chiral carbon. There must be a chiral carbon, no, optically active carbon. That also divided into two types, L form and D form. I told you the one which rotate anticlockwise, L form. The one which rotate the plane polarized light clockwise, D form. That is the classification. Then this isomerism again divided into what? Functional group isomerism, chain isomerism, and that is not much important. Chain isomerism, position isomerism, and they don't ask much that this one in the exam. But anyway, that also you have to refer here. Position and functional group isomerism. So given two isomers, which are not mirror images of each other, that is wrong. Can this possible? Because after when you cancel the if enantiomers are not present, enantiomers are not there, mirror images are not, they have not given the enantiomer, but they have given mirror images. When now, if you don't know the relationship between the mirror images and enantiomerism, then that was a problem. Other than that, is this the only one left? No, this side also there. No chain, position, and functional group isomers are also there. So actually, this is what that whether you know this flow diagram. This is given in the resource book also. That's what they test in the second statement. The first statement is what? All the compounds having double bonds, will they show diastereoisomerism? No. This one, no, the isotuberosimilism, this alkene, see here, this side also both the groups are identical, this side also both the groups are identical. This one, there's no isotuberosimilism here. All the alkenes are not showing isotuberosimilism. What is the answer for the 45th MCQ? 2020 A-level paper. Yes, answer is both the statements are wrong. Both the statements are wrong. Both the statements are wrong. Yeah, Pramodhi, your second attempt correct. Very good. What about the others? Others didn't tell anything. Ishara, you mean the third answer for this, you mean true and false, right? That's what you mean. Others didn't reply. Did you understand? Pramodhi first gave false and true and then gave false, false. Okay, correct. Later you understood. Ishara, okay, right. Tamasha? Is that clear, Tamasha? Was the statement wrong? Do you understand that? Okay. Right. Both are wrong. Okay. Right. Now you can understand the potential of this teaching, like this last week and this week, what to learn from me. So this importance, when you answer in the recent new syllabus papers, you can see the areas where they mostly raise questions from organic chemistry. Okay. Isomerism part, and then alkanes reaction, free radical substitution reaction. Today you learn electrophilic addition, alkenes, right? Not all the reactions, sometimes there is, okay. Then that, the next one also, benzene, I will start next week. Huh? Benzene, we didn't do it. That's what I'm going to start next. Benzene thing, I will start next week. That's, then remind me to discuss this one. That's also organic chemistry. Right. See, this is also organic compound here. They're asking which one lie on the same plane, same lie, straight line like that. The hybridization matters. Now, question number 32. Can you see the organic chemistry again? That is organic chemistry and general chemistry combined. Right? Hybridization. Can you tell me the answer for the 32? Question number 32. From your hybridization knowledge and organic chemistry knowledge. This, the terminal one is aldehyde group. And this is alkyne. Can you guess the answer for this? There's oxygen here, ether also there. Yes. If you know the hybridization, you can decide easily. This is SP, right? This is SP. This is SP2. This is SP3. This is SP3. Because there are two lone pairs, oxygen. Now you can easily decide the answer. Can you tell me the answer for the 32? Now you can see this, the questions from this organic chemistry section, they have given under ABCD type and statement questions. The hardest questions in the paper you get in ABCD type and statement questions. Now I'll do one thing. You get, okay, what happens now after 6-7 months, you will forget now what you learned today, like to a certain extent, not you will remember, now you will not remember now. Today you understood 100%. By tomorrow, like gradually, it's what happens. So 5%, it becomes 90%, 80%, like that. After, if you don't study, if you don't answer any questions from isomerism and this part, mechanisms of organic reactions, then automatically you'll remember this. You will forget it, right? You will forget it. So you don't need to make effort to forget it. Now, therefore, I thought of uploading all these recordings. Recording, I'll upload separately and I'll put into YouTube separately. So later you can, if you are struggling to get it, then again, you can't do a class. No, you can't get again individual division. Like then instead of that, you can quickly refer that. Okay, I'll label that one when I did the IUPAC nomenclature part. I'll record, label that video, recording video as IUPAC nomenclature. And then isomerism part, when I teach that one, I put, that recording I'll store separately in my device, and later I hope to upload all this into YouTube channel. Then you can watch them whenever you want. When you are doing the questions in the future, when the oral exam is closed, when you answer the questions, if you are struggling, then if you can't remember, then again, you care to look at your notes, so then you can understand. You need my explanation. Like some parts, you understand when I teach like this, but from the note, it takes more time for to understand, right? Because the way that you copy down the note. So therefore, it will be beneficial. So I thought of, but previous one I didn't do like that. But upcoming ones, I thought of doing like that. Right. So after you can get the recording within 3 days, you can watch it any number like in times. But then later, then it will be a problem. It will be automatically deleted from the Zoom cloud because of lacking storage. Therefore, I thought of I'll download all those videos, and one day I'll when the exam is closed, that will be beneficial to you. Then you can do the questions again, and you can, if you want, you can refer and you can watch the recording. So the that video. Right. I will share the link with next week. Most probably I'll try to finish that. You can directly watch from the YouTube channel the videos of the previous lessons. Question number 32, I gave enough time. What is the answer now? 32, Tamasha gave B and C, Pramodhi gave A and B. What about HR and Minhara? Yes? Think about the angles and the hybridization. Then you can get, when you look at the angles, bond angles and hybridization, you can decide whether it's straight line or not, or whether it's the same plane or not. So SP3 hybridization, it will be never in the same plane, right? Okay, actually the answer is, Tamasha, your answer is, okay, Tamasha gave the answer, B and C, very good. Answer is B and C. B and C. B and C. B and C means answer is second, right? Ishara correct, Tamasha correct. Okay, I will draw the structure. Please copy down everyone. Okay, I'll expand this and draw according to the angles. So this is how it looks. Always remember this triple bond, carbon, carbon, triple bond, that is in a straight line. Look at here, triple bond, it is SP, so angle will be 180. You have learned that this angle is 180. SP hybridization, this is 180. Around this also, it's 180. 180 degrees. That is very simple. That we have already learned. Then this must be a straight line. So this atom also a straight line with that, and this carbon also a straight line. Carbon atom T. Then what happened? This is trigonal planar. This aldehyde group. Aldehyde group, that C, this one. So that is this oxygen and hydrogen not in the same plane. Here you have to do again carbon. So because there are two lone pairs here. So the angular bend. And then you get here carbon. Here hydrogen, and here hydrogen. So tetrahedron, tetrahedron. Now atoms label PQRS. PQRS means what? Are they in the same straight line? No. P is not in the straight line. Here CP, I put P, P is, CP is not a straight line. Because it's not in the same line. That's why A is wrong. Pramodhi, did you understand now? A is wrong. You should better draw this, everyone. I don't know whether you understood this. You should better draw this. Then it's easy to get the answer. I highlight that green. A is wrong. B is correct, no? B is correct. C also correct. D is wrong. Understood. I don't want to explain you when you look at the structure that I given. So this is 100, approximately 130, yeah, not exactly. This is 120 degrees. 120 degrees. is 120. This one around 100 and like, but not, it can slightly change. Huh? It's within a certain range, it can, yeah. Okay, so the, what is the answer for this? A, B and C means answer is second. B and C means answer is second. Is that clear? Shara correct. Tamasha correct. Very good. Pramodian Vinhara. Right. RSTU, oxygen is not with the straight line with the others. Huh? That's why the oxygen also not in the straight line. Here, this carbon also I highlight, they're not in the straight line. Which ones are in a straight line? Three carbon atoms and this oxygen. I highlight them blue. The blue ones are straight line. This one, and this. Otherwise, it will not be in the. That means QRST. QRST is straight line. Yeah, straight line. Right. Okay, shall I erase this? I hope you understood, right? Pramodian Vinhara, right. If you have any more questions, you can ask before I erase this, right? See, now you can see what this question is, what? It is like organic chemistry combined with general chemistry, hybridization bond angles combined with organic chemistry. Actually, this is again organic. This one we can't discuss it because benzene content one will do it. Again, organic pump, benzene, aromatic ones, I'll discuss within next few weeks. So here again, organic compound with relative molecular mass, they have asked here. Then you have to consider what? Aldehyde and alcohol and alkane. So relative molecular mass, all this same. So then what happened to the boiling point? You had done with me, right? The aldehyde and alcohol, which one can form hydrogen bonds? Only? So here relative molecular mass same, then what matters? Intermolecular forces. Alcohol has hydrogen bonding. Can aldehyde form hydrogen bonding? Can't. Can aldehyde form hydrogen bonding? Can't. Can this aldehyde form hydrogen bonding? Can't. So they have what? Dipole. Both C and D, dipole. And this one? Both this what? London forces or dispersion. Is organic chemistry combined with boiling points. Can you guess the answer for this also? 11th MCQ. Can you guess the answer? This is also 2020 A-level paper. Organic chemistry combined with the physical properties of organic compounds, boiling point. Sometimes they can ask water solubility. Which one has the highest boiling point out of all these? Which one will be, now one by one you can omit the most incorrect answer. Which one has the lowest boiling point and which one has the highest boiling point? That's what you should check first. Then you can easily get, no need to arrange them one by one first. First check the one with highest and one with lowest. So definitely the highest boiling point will be what? The least one. Alcohol, because that one can form hydrogen bonding. And because dipole and these London forces are weaker than that. So the strength is highest hydrogen bonding, then dipole, weakest interaction by London forces. Highest E, then lowest. Can you post the answer to that? linear one or a branch chain can form more van der Waal forces. That's what you have to predict first. Linear one or out of these two, which one can form more van der Waal forces? Linear one or the branch one can has more, I can get exposed more for the van der Waal forces to form van der Waal forces. When there are more R groups, when there's linear one, they can form more van der Waal forces. I highlight both this. When the linear chain can form more van der Waal forces than the branch chain one. Linear is also linear. Can form a strong van der Waal or London forces. Can you please write down? Linear, when the chain become linear, the strength is more. Linear one can form more stronger London forces. Please write it if you don't know. Linear chain can form strong van der Waal or London forces. Strong London forces. This also a strong one. Then out of C and D, C will be higher. C will be higher. Out of C and D, both aldehyde, C and D. Both having dipole. Both having the same relative molecular mass. So then C is strong van der Waal forces because it's linear. Strong intermolecular forces, strong dipole-dipole, strong dipole-dipole, I put DP-DP, then the other one. So whether it's an aldehyde or whether it's an alkane, when the chain become linear, linear carbon chain can form a strong van der Waal forces. Linear carbon chain can form stronger London forces than the branch one. That's what I want you to remember. Now tell me the answer. This is what you need to get the answer. Highest alcohol because of hydrogen bonding, and that chain also linear. That chain also linear. Both the factors are favorable for alcohol. Linear carbon chain and OH group. Highest E. Then which one is lowest? Lowest will be B. Lowest will be B. Then you can guess the answer easily. Now post the answer to the chat. Everyone. Lowest B. Highest A. Lowest B, highest A. Got it? Lowest this, highest this. Okay, let's see answers. Now I need the answer from everyone, the correct answer, because I explain everything. Okay, Vinhara correct, Ishara correct, Pramadi correct. Tamasha? Very good. All right. All are correct. Now understood. So what did you learn now? The strength of intermolecular forces matters. Relative molecular mass matters. So what are the factors affecting the boiling point? Relative molecular mass, strength of intermolecular force, number of intermolecular force. Relative molecular mass, strength of intermolecular force, number of intermolecular force in case of organic and covalent compounds. Inorganic, in case of organic compounds as well as when you compare organic as well as inorganic covalent compounds. Organic covalent compounds also there, inorganic covalent compounds also there. If you take HCl, HBr, HI, inorganic covalent. Inorganic covalent molecules. If you take glucose, galactose, or the disaccharide, monosaccharide, or alcohol, they are organic covalent compounds. So what are the factors affecting those both organic and inorganic covalent compounds, the boiling point, the strength of intermolecular force, relative molecular mass and number of intermolecular forces. So here relative molecular mass same. Then what are the other two factors that will affect? Strength of intermolecular force and number of intermolecular force. Strength of intermolecular force highest alcohol. And then the others, when you compare the similar compounds with the same functional group, number of intermolecular forces or number of London forces, so the strength highest in the linear one. Linear one can form. So please remember, when you are doing, when you are drawing the chain isomerism, this matters. I'll give one example. Shall I erase this? Okay, I want you to get the, I need the answer for this also. I will draw pentane. Look at here, everyone. Okay, please copy down this. Comparison of the isomers of pentane, the boiling point. I'll tell, please tell me which one has the highest melting point. Boiling point. Look at this. First, try draw this pentane, CH linear one, CH3, CH2, CH2, CH3. What is pentane? Then the next one I'll draw CH3, CH. This is butane, no? I'll make it pentane. CH3, CH2, CH2, CH3, right. The next one I'll put CH3, CH. CH2, CH3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Like this, CH3 here. And here CH3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, okay. So this is the first one, this is the second one. 2-methyl butane. Third one I'll put CH3, 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 CH3. It's also, what is it, all these having the same, what is C5H12? All these pentane, all these are pentane. Now tell me which one has the, please copy down this everyone. Comparison of the isomer, boiling point of the isomers of pentane. Please copy down that. Comparison of the boiling point of the isomers of pentane. Comparison of the boiling point of the isomers of pentane. There are three isomers. What are these three isomers now? Chain isomers. Due to the changing of the carbon chain. Chain isomers. Chain isomers of pentane. Carbon chain is different. Pentane. This is just pentane, 2-methyl pentane. Then you get 2,2-dimethyl propane. 2,2-dimethyl propane. I don't have time to write down the isomer name. You can write. Now tell me which one has, out of 1, 2, 3, which one has the, 1, 2, 3 boiling point increase or decrease? 1, 2, 3 boiling point increase or decrease? Tell me, reply. Downwards, boiling point increase or decrease? You can tell because I explained in the 2020 LL paper what happens to when the chain become branch and linear. Down the group, what happened down here? Downwards, from 1 to 2 to 3, the boiling point? Decrease, very good. Boiling point decrease. Can you please copy down this? Boiling point decrease. Decreases. Now that means what? They have similar chemical properties, but physical properties are different. Chain isomers having different physical properties because boiling point is a physical property. Chemical properties same. All are hydrocarbons, same molecular weight, same. And what is the type of interaction here? Same type, molecular weight same. And all three having London induced dipole, London forces. But the strength of London forces changes with the surface area of the molecule. Is that clear? Okay. Very good. I think you understood this now. Yeah. Now you don't need to make the same weight on all the parts of inorganic chemistry or organic chemistry. There are areas where you get the questions. Those areas, who knows? The teachers, they know that. Those who have very good experience about the past papers and the LL chemistry syllabus, they know which area is more important. If you pay more attention, if you concentrate more on those areas, you can easily go for the A-pass chemistry. But for you, everything same. When you study the resource book, when you look at the resource book, you don't know which part is more important. You have to put more weight, more concentration, which you don't have. Then that's why you need the teacher's help. Now, when you are doing this small bit of theory with me and the summary, and when you go for the questions, you can understand that. Right. Okay. So, 2020 paper itself, now we discuss sort of organic MCQs now, right? Okay. Now, actually, that the alkene reaction paper and discuss. Question name shall discuss that next day. Okay. IUPAC name, this one also we discussed. Now IUPAC name, this compound we discussed, right? Yeah. 2020 paper also we added. Yeah. Now organic chemistry, most of the organic chemistry ones except the aromatic ones I discussed 2020 paper also now. Now this paper without my help you can try it at home now. This what is this? This paper. Organic isomerism, not that one. Organic isomerism, this paper we discuss. Alkene reaction one. Organic, this one. So this one I want you to know, today I discuss this with you. I want you to do this for homework, this paper. Because if I explain and give the answer, then like you can try this at home and come. Next day I'll discuss this paper, right? Organic alkene reaction. Now next day I'll do the aromatic compound benzene, reactions of benzene next week. Aromatic one, I'll discuss next day reactions. And 2020 A level paper, today I did the organic ones. Ne? 2020 A level paper, I want you to do general and inorganic MCQs. And 2019 paper, A level paper, question number up to 14th MCQ, we have done inorganic. The rest you have to do. So that's what we are going to discuss next week. I will be discussing this paper, the answers, alkene reaction, this paper, homework. And 19 and 20 paper, general and inorganic MCQs and aromatic compounds theory. And I'll do that also. I'll post the paper, right? So it's almost 10:30, then we'll stop for today, right? Okay, then I'll stop for today and good night and God bless you all.
Thank you, sir. Good night.